Hi, I'm Brian English, Wappler forum name Hyperbytes, and in this module I'm just going to take you on a brief tour of the interface of Wappler. Bit of time travel here, because this is actually about the end of the unit on security, so we're about 11 lessons ahead here, but miracles of the internet, I can move this module to a preamble. I just needed something to be open on the page so I could show you the various options. So very briefly, we have two sides to the screen. We have the right hand side here. This is the App Connect side of things. So that's basically the things that you will be using to create the page structures and the page layouts. It's the bit that you would see in your web browser basically. And over on the left-hand side here, primarily, is our Server Connect panel. That's all of the actions that will take place at server level, which obviously tend not to be seen in a web browser. These are the background tasks. And then we have a line of menu options down the left-hand side here as well. So just very briefly, the App Structure panel we're going to spend a lot of time in, because this is where we basically build the front end of our pages. So you can see there which app, that basically tells us that App Connect is loaded. We can go into our framework section and we can see that App Connect local is installed. Bootstrap 5 local is installed, and generally we will also have Font Awesome 5 in place as well. And that's the setup that I've got things defined as. When we're in any component or section within that App Connect container structure, you can see that we have the properties of that particular item. So we can see in this case, this is a container with a margin top of 5. It's fixed container, and again we can change that to fluid or responsive, etc. We have some preset layouts. We can change our text color alignment, etc. We can change our background colors and alignments. We have the ability to, by drag and drop, just to be able to change the margins, paddings and gutters, etc. We can introduce borders to elements to make them stand out, and we can hide certain elements if we want to on certain devices. So perhaps there might be a video you don't want to show on a phone but you want to show on a computer. And lastly, you can also choose when an item will appear if somebody hits a print button. Every element has some dynamic attributes. They are the effectively dynamic properties that we can add. Dynamic events also. We can switch the way, by the way, up here if you don't want to scroll. So an events here, and again these are events that happen under certain circumstances. So if it's input blur, keyboard press down, mouse click is a very common one, touch pointers. And every element within that will have properties. Some of them will have slightly different properties to others for obvious reasons. This is our add new component action. So we can do that, and that pops up all of the different things that we can add. And these arrows are insert before, insert after, and insert child. That, in other words, inside. We can also pop that up by just right clicking on the element, or if we're actually in the section itself, we could also use these plus and minus buttons, etc. So for instance, if I'm in a container, we could add stuff into that particular container by clicking on buttons in here. Duplicate, to duplicate an item, the cross is simply delete an item. We've seen the frameworks will deal with move to partials at a later stage. We also have a design screen which allows us to look at extended properties, things like dimensions and positions of things, type of text that's used, things like container backgrounds, colours, images, etc., borders. We've also got a style section, and obviously this is, requires a style sheet to be attached. At the moment, basically, we're just seeing the bootstraps sections, but as we move between the items, you'll see that the styles screen will change to tell you which styles are applied to that particular element. Then lastly, we've got the document object model, which again allows us to pick out a particular item via its ID. We're discussing IDs at a later stage, and then again there will be particular properties that are relevant to those, and also dynamic properties and events, and static events, of course. So that's basics up there. That is simply a reload button. We can choose different themes for Wappler from there. Reload your design view. We've got, this is an interesting one, clicking on this will pop up a QR code. If you scan that on your mobile device, you will see what this web page would look like on your mobile device. It's really useful to be able to check that you've got the responsive settings correct. We have a open and browser button. We have a toggle app connect mode. So basically, app connect mode basically means that it's running live inside your view screen here. Take it out and it's not. And then again, we've got some items here. So we can component edit mode, text mode if we want to. Information will give us information about the particular component that is selected on there. We have accessibility settings and visibility settings. So it's a really rich in terms of its functionality. We got design view, we have a code view, and of course one of the beauties of Wappler is that it produces standard HTML5 based code, so you're talking about straightforward HTML and JavaScript, and you can also work in a split screen as well if you wish. We can also see what our web page will look like within different devices. So we got large, we got down to a laptop, down to a tablet, down to a phone in landscape, down to a phone in portrait. And we can actually, by reference to things like your margin spacing settings, if you work through mobile first, always the best advice, start with mobile first, you can actually select the column and you can size it accordingly. Then as you move through the different sizes, you can set individual sizes for that particular type of device, so that your screen will adjust itself as required. Along the top here we have our project definitions, which we'll be looking at in detail very soon. This simply will make the project thumbnail, so your project settings will take whatever you've clicked on as the thumbnail. Over here we have first of all our site manager, where we can look at pages, or we can look in a files view. Assets are it's the repository for you to store things like your images, videos, etc., and there is a search facility in there. We have Git. We can create local or remote Git repositories. One place we'll spend a lot of time, this is the inbuilt database manager, and allow us to manage databases from directly from within Wappler, rather than having to worry about external database management systems. Sorry, I just seem to skip there. Workflows, this is huge workflows. That's basically where we would define what happens with all of our API actions. We've got routing, we'll be using Node. Node is a fully routed language, so every page will be referred to by its root rather than its actual page name. And when you create a page within this screen, the pages screen, that routing is automatically created for you. We have Bootstrap Theme Manager, where you can redefine your Bootstrap theme totally. Then we have a Resource Manager, which allows us to look at the different types of cloud providers that we might use, for instance DigitalOcean or Hertz or something like that. And then lastly, we've also got our project settings button here, which is exactly the same as clicking the pencil icon up here. Just down the bottom here we have our project manager, which will show all the projects that are set up on your machine. We have extensions screen, which will show all of the extensions that are installed on your system. And then lastly we have a general options to allow you to do things like change the code editor, split views, Docker settings, database naming conventions, etc. It's really best bet is just to play with that. NG Rock Auth token, I'm just going to mention because we will be introducing that very soon. Here we'll show you what your account is and what your options are. And one important one I forgot to mention here is when we're in our workflows, there is a settings button here which allows you to define the number of settings in relation to your server environment. And this is an important one, is here we'll be talking about debug mode, and this is how we debug any server action should they throw an error. Lastly, down at the bottom here we've got an output window, so we can look at the output, we can look at web server outputs, ngrok I think it is pronounced, proxy details, anything to do with Stripe, a web hoop. So we also have a terminal window where we can issue commands like npms etc. We have a system check button, we have a clear screen button, we have a debug commands button. And these settings here are relative to what you're doing in relation to your target. But basically that's your stop start local server, your restart it, kill it completely, and check for updates. So that's a very, very brief run around the interface of Wappler. We'll be looking at all these components in more detail in a moment. But at least now, if I say, well, we pop over into the workflows panel, for instance, you will actually understand what I'm talking about. So I hope to have you join me again sometime in the very near future.